Generally, I would say that most computer scientists believe that P does not equal NP. And there are basically two reasons for that. The first reason is the power of non-determinism, the power of guessing correctly. It kind of seems strange that that should be possible always in polynomial time. And the second reason, and unfortunately we'll only briefly touch that in this course, is that there are problems that are believed to be even much harder than NP-complete problems, and P equals NP would imply that also these much harder problems would be solvable in polynomial time. The high chances that P does not equal NP is of course what makes resolving the P versus NP question much harder. Because if we wanted to show that P equals NP, then all we would have to find is one single polynomial time algorithm for an NP-complete problem. But if we want to show that P does not equal NP, then we'll have to construct some mathematical proof that takes into account any conceivable algorithm, no matter how sophisticated or thought through or advanced. As long as that algorithm runs in polynomial time, we must show that it cannot solve an NP-complete problem. Now, as famous as the P versus NP question is, there's some heated debate on whether that would actually have any practical consequences. On the theoretical level, of course, it would be a fantastic result, and the person who manages to resolve P versus NP would become quite famous. But on a practical level, there's two things to consider. One is that polynomial time doesn't always mean efficiency. So as you've seen with the NP completeness proof of SAT, the polynomials involved quickly get very large. And of course, a polynomial time algorithm with a time of, say, n to the power of 20 would not really be practical. And on the other hand, because NP complete problems are so important in practice, there's lots of techniques that have been developed to actually deal with them. And we'll learn some of them in this course, of course. In any case, if you want to spark a heated debate between theoretical computer scientists, should you ever have the opportunity to do so, then just ask them whether resolving P versus NP would have any practical consequences.